Na program zaprasza grupa CCC, właściciel marki Spranding.
Jako nastolatek marzył o tym, żeby zostać zawodowym piłkarzem. Szło mu całkiem nieźle, był bramkarzem. Dzisiaj spotyka się z Edenem Hazardem, z Kevinem De Bruyne, z innymi gwiazdami belgijskiej piłki. On sam jednak postawił na kolarstwo i zrobił bardzo dobrze. Dzisiaj jest mistrzem olimpijskim z Rio de Janeiro. I właśnie Greg Van Averen będzie naszym gościem w koło ekstra. Zapraszam. Razem ze mną mistrz olimpijski, jeden z najlepszych kolarzy na świecie, Greg Van Avermaet, ale zaczniemy rozmowę nie od kolarstwa. Greg, who is the best football goalkeeper all over the world?
Thibaut Courtois.
I hope that you said Wojciech Szczęsny. Do you think that Greg Van Avermaet could be one of them if he decide to continue his football career?
No, I don't think so. If you see overall, the top goalkeepers for the moment, they have to be over 1.90 m. I'm a little bit too small. I think I just play a little bit on character and hard working. So probably not enough to be a top world class goalkeeper.
Sometimes you are going to football pitch and try to play, or?
Less and less. I think when I was younger, I did a lot. I did every day. But as a cyclist, it's so specific. You have to be really focused on your own training. You can damage your muscles a bit with falling down, and I think 2 years ago I tried. I was on a training of my team, Maslon Beveren, who is the first division team. I tried to do a little bit of falling down and catching some balls. It still worked, but afterwards I was a few days stiff. So I focus on cycling for the moment.
Your club Beveren is famous because of goalkeepers. There was Jean-Michel Pfaff, for example, and you're completely sure that you couldn't be one of them.
No, I think they had a good education. I think they had some good trainers, and they were really specific on goalkeepers because most of them, some good young good goalkeepers, still made it to the national team. But for me, I think football is more complex than cycling. You need a lot of help from the outside, and having a good trainer who believes in you means a lot of difference in your career. Whereas a cyclist, if you perform well and you have a good attitude and you have the capability to do something, I think it's easier for a cyclist to prove yourself.
Who is more popular in Belgium, you or Eden Hazard?
Eden Hazard, yeah. He's an international star. I think in Belgium, everybody knows there are the top supporters like me, Hazard, Gilbert. For we are known, but outside of Belgium, Hazard is a bigger picture. And if you play with Real Madrid, everybody knows you.
What is your goal for this season? I know that you probably said this is Olympic, but I think it's Tour of France.
Yeah, both. I think first of all, I want to be good in classics from Nieuwsblad until Amstel. It's a really important period. Of course, with the Tour of Flanders as my home race, a lot of people there, a nice atmosphere. I like also the atmosphere around the race.
A lot of riders told me that in Flanders it's something magic.
Yeah, I think so. If you ask the whole peloton what's their favorite race to ride, you know, for the atmosphere, the ambiance before, after, during the race, I think a lot of people, riders, will say like it's Flanders, because in the start the full square is full of people, they make music, the ambiance is good, you feel a good vibe. Also during the race, every town you pass like full of people, some kermesse, things to do. And this kind of special feeling, I think, for a rider to feel so much support from outside the bunch.
Polish fans are crazy when see ski jumpers. Belgian fans are crazy when see cyclists.
Yeah, you can tell it. Yeah, like this. I
think. Do you like ski jumping?
I like ski jumping, but I cannot do. I think it's a bit crazy to go from that height down. So. I'm not gonna try.
Okay, back to cycling. Do you really believe that you can be one of the strongest in Tokyo?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. I think if I come good out of the Tour de France with good shape, good weight, it's really important, I think, because it's a climber course. I still have a chance, and I think it's a quite similar parkour than to Rio. It was also not a big favorite, but I won.
Everybody was talking before Rio that it's only for climbers, and then Greg Van Avermaet didn't know it, and won.
Yeah, so I hope a little bit the same now in Tokyo. I think they say the same. Bigger favorites are Geraint Thomas, Froome, Roglic. They're all capable to win, but I think I'm a one-day specialist, and on one day I can sometimes do things that are better than other days. So I think if I have a super good day, I'm capable to maybe go for a second medal.
Do you saw this course?
No, I didn't see the course in real, but yeah, with the new techniques of cycling now, you can see on the website, you can see Google Earth, you can search every percentage on every gram. So I think on this kind of things, you see if you're capable to do. And the biggest for me important thing is like we have small teams of 5-4 riders each country, and this is really hard to control the race. And I think that's could be a benefit for me.
What are the other difference between Olympics and normal race?
It's something special because you're in the same village with all other athletes. If you like sports, it's quite impressive to see Michael Phelps or Usain Bolt next to you, you know.
Or
Van Avermaet. So no, I think it's, for us, if you're a sports fan, it's something really attracting. That's one difference, and yeah, it's a race you cannot compare. When you go with your team, you have your own teammates, you have your chef, you prepare, you go with the bus of the team to the race. Olympics, it's everything together, small teams, more house, so it's kind of a different circumstances.
Back to CCC, Greg, what do you think, what can do CCC team in this season? I'm asking because first year was hard for everybody, but I think the second should be much better.
Yeah, I think so. I think we can make good progression. I think we did some good signings. Second year, like you say, we know each other. We have a strong team next to us, and I think we can deliver some good results. And I think we just have to be patient. We already did the biggest races, which is not easy, you know. And I think we will try to do well, and I think the results will follow.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Wiecie już, czemu Greg Van Avermaet nie został piłkarzem? Teraz spotkamy się z inną, bardzo ciekawą postacią. Człowiekiem, którego w światowym kolarstwie znają wszyscy. Z prezydentem ekipy CTC, Jimem Machowiczem. Razem ze mną prezydent CTC Team, Jim Machowicz. Hi, Jim.
Hello, how are you?
Great. Jim, do you think that the second season with CCC will be much better than first?
Well, it depends on what you're using as a measurement, but I think in terms of the quality of the team, yes, we've upgraded the status of the players on the roster, and that should translate into some more opportunities for the team to look at races that fit our style of racing and allow us to hopefully find some new adventures in 2020.
In teams, there is few new names. Do you think that guys like Ilnur Zakarin or Matteo Trentin should win a few stages or maybe classics?
They're very capable of doing all that. So that's the reason they're on the team is because it's going to allow us to be able to race a little bit differently, a little more aggressively. They have won big races in their careers already. So having to do it again is not a big surprise, or maybe doing it again is not a big surprise. But I think that, yes, it also really gives the team new objectives, more objectives, and will put us in a different place in regards to how the race develops and how we strategize the tactics going in and out of the races.
When you was the boss of BMC and then first year in CCC, it was the team which was better in classics. Do you think it will be still like in the past, or the team will also find his opportunities in stages race?
we demonstrated in 2019 we can do the classics. Greg won Montreal, which is a World Tour race. We have similar goals for 2020 with the addition of Matteo Trentin. That makes me source of power in the peloton in those classic style races which you talked about. But in the stage races in 2019, we didn't really have a GC contender. But now with Zakarin and Hirt and others on the roster, and younger people coming up with talent, we're probably going to see some nice results in the 1 week stage races in the World Tour, and probably surprise some people in the Grand Tours as well.
I must ask you about Poland, because you've got the surname, which is quite Polish.
It's not quite Polish. It's Polish. I'm come from Milwaukee as a young man. That's where I was born. And that's where my grandfather immigrated to. We're not sure what the roots are in Poland or yet, but we've not been able to historically find that spot. But he certainly came in with a Polish name, and I'm still holding the name. So yes, we have some roots back in that area somewhere. And I'm very proud of that. And it was a coincidence of some sort to have me meet Mr. Miwik and put this team together in 2019. So it's a privilege for me to work with all the great partners I have from the prior CCC team that are very capable people in management, coaching, and other staffing members, plus the riders that came with the organization. And so we've all integrated well together, and we're working hard to find some success.
You worked with few Polish riders. Which one was the best?
You know, I don't have a favorite. I think that there's quite a group of young kids that we're developing right now, this coming in the first year. So I think that we'll see how those kids develop. They're not kids, these are young men, but I call them kids. But they're gonna have a challenge this year with some good races to see where they can take themselves.
Okay. Thank you very much, okay. And I hope that next time we will talk in Polish.
That might not happen, but I'll
Thank
try.
You. Thank you.
Thank you.
Program zaprosiła grupa CCC, właściciel marki Sprandi.